In the movie 2611, the question that is often asked by the audience, by the people in the hotel is, what happened since that evening when the attack happened, and why did the National Security Guard, which was stationed then and only in Delhi, take so much time to reach Mumbai?
I was an insider. I am an insider, and hence whatever I say will be my word versus somebody's word. So before I start what really happened, I would suggest people to access Sandeep Unnithang, a journalist who had perfectly documented what happened and how the NSG was available for departure from midnight onwards after the deployment had been ordered and they had been transported.
So they were in Manesar, and from Manesar
they had been brought into technical area of Palam Airport by around midnight.
But they reached Mumbai only by about 5 in the morning.
The reason is, number one, the Honorable Minister, the then Honorable Minister in charge, Mr. Shivaraj Patil, said, I will accompany the NSG team.
Why? Why does a minister need to accompany?
That is for the minister to answer. And number two is, he took 2 hours. We kept on asking him that the NSG team is waiting. Please, sir, please, sir. And he could only at 2 o'clock respond. We had asked him other alternative proposals, like withdrawing local available resources and deploying them as an interim measure. Even for that, he did not consent. Mind you, the other decision makers in the Home Ministry were in Pakistan at that time. It's all documented. They had gone for the Home Secretary level talks. So I could not take.
So you mean the CRPF, which was stationed in central units there, the CISF and the airport?
CRPF.
They're all trained.
Been deployed as an interim measure, and CISF, mind you, is the expert in vital installation security. So they could have handled the 2 hotels and CST attack in a very, very positive way. They could have mitigated a lot of damage.
The number of people killed down could have been far less.
They could have taken control of the situation. Having said that, since the NSG has been, even till date, I have to flag one thing, even till date, there is no official order which says that in case of that, as an interim measure, these type of locally available resources can be deployed. There is no order to that, but notwithstanding that, the minister has full powers, the secretary has full powers.
So he reached the airport at what time?
It was around 2:20 he reached the airport.
Shivaraj Patil.
And for more than 2 hours, the NSC boys were waiting in the aircraft and in a cold night, waiting in the aircraft and sitting in a position.
So you were at the control room in the Ministry of Home Affairs?
I was at control room. See, I want to flag one more thing about it. NSG's core competence is about agility. If before going on a ops, if you are asked to wait in the aircraft, in an ideal aircraft for 2 hours, it stiffens their movement, their limbs and all that. So that agility can also be a little impaired. That is a different matter. Even after landing in Mumbai, Shivaraj Patil expected proper official protocol, which further delayed the NSG by another half an hour. So that is the reason it took almost 3 hours. Even
what would have been a 2-hour flight from Delhi to Mumbai took almost something like 5 hours.
5 hours, and that is the reason. This was a war. So every minute we were ceding to the terrorists, we were strengthening their positions, strategic positions.
Was it an inside job? Because there was a news that how did these people easily walk through the Koliwada? How did they get a taxi so easily in an area where you hardly get taxis? And what about the fact that there was supposed to be a civil servant from the Maharashtra cadre, I'm not really sure, but somebody who was inside the hotel who walked away cleanly without even a scratch?
I have already come out on public and said that 2611 was a fixed match between ISI and local Congress government in power. Having said that, about the civil servant, she was not an ordinary civil servant. Chitkala Joshi was additional chief secretary, home, government of Maharashtra. All the inputs after the chief secretary's table would land in her table by virtue of her domain area. So it is simply not acceptable that she was not aware of it. She was very much aware of the possibilities of attack, a vital installation located in coastal areas, etc. So there is no question of her being oblivious of the information. She had the intelligence inputs right after the chief secretary level, she would have it on her table. So to that extent, it can be very safely concluded that she had the information. What was she doing? Her presence in the...
She was in the touch. She was in touch.
Is certainly there's a question mark about it. The bigger question mark is, how did she come? How did she leave the Taj Hotel unhurt? Is the bigger question mark. So these are all questions which the nation begs for an answer. It has not come the last 11 years.
So suppose Kasab was not captured, what would have been the narrative? Because we did see Digvijay Singh saying that this was an RSS conspiracy.
RSS Ki Saajish was a book which was already in print during 2008 when this was concurrently happened. So that is also gives credence to the theory, because the release of the book was deferred by 2 years. It is by Amish Barni or Anish Barni. It was deferred by 2 years, but it was already available. That's for the inputs available at that extent time. In December 2008 or 2009, we had some inputs like that the book has already in the book. The new minister who had taken over after the 2611 attack was also aware of the availability of the book.
But so there was an attempt to kidnap you and trade you off with Kasab.
Yes.
I heard something like that. Is it true?
It is true, and there is a report of the Delhi police which I have placed in the book also, a copy of which is book. And interestingly, if you see that report of the Delhi police, it looked like a doctored report, because first thing is when a report from the Home Ministry saying that our officer has been chased and these type of violent attempts have been made on his when he was driving in the street, the Delhi police did not register an FIR. That should have been done. There was no FIR registered. Secondly, if you read the report which the Delhi police furnished on the event incident, it is very clear that the police post where I approached for help was practically empty at the time I reported. That means it was emptied. Not empty. And you don't leave a police post empty, because it could be very vital witnesses, vital undertrials, or maybe...
So in a sense, if you look back right now and say, do you feel there should be an inquiry into the entire thing by somebody at a very senior level, at a bureaucratic, maybe a judicial level, into 2611?
A retired judge certainly, or a judicial level inquiry, she is certainly required to get much more, because Ajmal Kasab has been hanged and he was caught alive, he has been hanged. But having said that, I will take you back to one more thing. On the 11th December 2008, see, after the 2611 attack, the first time the parliament was convened was on 10th December 2008. First day of the parliament, as normal as the practice is, intercession period, whomsoever has passed away, the house is adjourned after obituary references to them. So 11th December 2008 was the first effective day of the session. Chidambaram gives a Suomoto statement in which he says, Indian Navy was, it is available on public domain, Indian Navy had, the intelligence was shared with Indian Navy and Principal Director of Intelligence Indian Navy and Coast Guard. More importantly, they had sighted the ship on 23rd of November in something like that in Pakistani international waters.
This is something that was often said, the Coast Guard had spotted it but it let the boat go. Is it true?
I will just complete that. Later on, there was no further Chidambaram statement, I am just sticking to purely to Chidambaram statement. Since further intelligence was not available, the Indian Navy or Coast Guard, both of them were single sister units, they abandoned the surveillance of the Delhi.
So basically they facilitated the entire entry of this terrorist into India.
I will not say like that, I will put it this way. No security agency in the country, having anywhere in the world, having spotted a hostile element, would ever abandon a surveillance.
So why
escalate it? That is one chance. If they have been asked to redeploy, look the other way. They have been redeployed. Also.
That's my question. So that means somebody in the government wanted these terrorists to enter Mumbai. Would you say that way?
we can always draw the logical conclusion will be only that. Based on the facts available on record, including P. Chidambaram's statement, the logical conclusion is that somebody very high in the government wanted to enter the...
Mr. Mani, thank you very much. I'm sure that your statements earlier made in the media and with this interview will surely provoke the government, especially after this movie, Hotel Mumbai was released. A lot of people have this question about how and why is of the attack on 26/11. I'm sure that we will see a very serious inquiry into the role of Shivraj Patel, into the role of the Indian Coast Guard in letting that particular boat go, in terms of the bureaucratics involved in the entire thing.
I want to flag one thing here. When there was no political intervention, 31st December 2014, when an attempt was made through the same coastal route by the same Pakistani groups, the Indian Coast Guard simply averted it. They simply repulsed the attack.
That means it could have happened again. Eh? If the attack could have happened again, Pakistan
no,
could
no,
have
no.
done something.
No, the security guards could repel the attack. They had the capacity. Political intervention stopped in 2008, but that there was no political intervention in 2014. So
2014 was when Mr. Modi was in power.
31st December 2014. I am not making any political statement about it. There are two instances of two eras.
So one was the UP era and one was the NDA era.
So that anybody can draw political conclusions on this. If 31st December they were well versed to repel an attack, 2008 also they were. But some intervention, some political intervention happened, maybe, or some high level intervention happened, and so they were allowed to come into the Mumbai. That is the some substance of it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for sharing these thoughts with us. I'm sure we'll have a lot more topics to discuss in the days to come.
Right, thank
this you is Suresh Kochatal signing off with Mr. R.V.S. Mani here in Hyderabad.